Good morning, everyone, and thank you for participating. My name is Fabio Tombolato, and I'm working as a technical service manager in OCSiAl Europe. Today, I want to show you how graphene nanotubes can help to develop and to produce high-performance coating with electrical properties and with a look at sustainability. I will give you a brief introduction of what graphene nanotubes are and which kind of properties they can bring to the material. And then I will focus on application in coating, especially industrial automotive application and textile as well. Graphene nanotubes, they are also called single-wall carbon nanotubes. They are namely made by a single sheet of graphene that is rolled up to form very thin, less than 2 nanometer, and very long, more than 5 microns, flexible tubes. Flexibility, together with a very high aspect ratio, together with a wall thickness of only one atom, gives to this material very peculiar properties. Thanks to the 3D network that they can create inside the polymer matrix, graphene nanotubes are known to be excellent at electrical conductors. In thermomechanical properties, they are 100 times stronger than steel. Just to give you an idea, the tensile strength of these materials lie in the range of terapascal. Graphene nanotubes, they are also ultralight material. Just to give you an idea, if you try to stretch 1 gram of graphene nanotubes, you will cover twice the distance between the Earth and the Sun. They are so versatile that it has been estimated that more than 50% of all materials could be enhanced introducing graphene nanotubes. They can be used, for example, for energy storage in the batteries. They can be used to improve the mechanical and electrical properties in construction material, in composite material as well. And for sure, they can be used in any kind of application for coating where conductivity, electrical properties are needed. Sustainability and eco-friendliness are two important points that need to be taken into consideration when developing a new product. And it has been demonstrated by an external independent study that introducing graphene nanotubes into the material to enhance the properties could contribute to the greenhouse gas emission reduction by a quantity of 6 billion tons equivalent to CO2 by 2050. Just to give you an idea, 6 billion tons is roughly 1/10 of the yearly GHG production. Tuball graphene nanotubes are the only single-wall carbon nanotubes that are registered to the European REACH, and they are authorized for commercialization up to 100 tons per year powder. Graphene nanotubes TUBALL are also available for US market. They are registered at APA authorization without any kind of limit in terms of volumes. And now let's focus on coatings application. There are different strategies, different additives that can be used to bring electrical properties to a coating. And they can be compared using the 6 parameters that we have represented in this spider chart. Carbon black, for example, is a well-known system, is a well-known filler that can be used to bring conductivity at a cheaper price, but it brings some limitation. Due to the dosage, it is difficult or even not possible to develop color products. Carbon black also can have negative effect on the mechanical properties of your coating, and for sure it has strong influence on the rheology of your coating. Furthermore, it is a powder, and it is sometimes not too easy to manage in a process in a clean environment. Conductive mica is another additive that you can use. For sure, it can solve some of these issues, but due to the high dosage needed to achieve conductivity, most of the time the cost could be an issue. Graphene nanotubes are the only additives that are able to bring properties in all these 6 parameters. Thanks to the very high efficiency, a very low working dosage, is needed to achieve permanent conductivity. We are saying that you can achieve conductivity starting from a dosage of 0.01, 0.02% in your final formulation. Thanks to the very low working dosage, it is possible to develop color product, and the mechanical properties of your system will remain not modified, unchanged, or even enhanced. As OCSiAl, we have developed a concentrate that helps the customer to manage graphene nanotubes in a very easy way in production, and with a very low impact on rheology, and what it is important, at an affordable price. As I told you before, nanotubes, graphene nanotubes, will bring electrical properties to your polymer thanks to the 3D network that they can create. And it is clear that dispersion for sure plays a crucial role. We, as OCSiAl, took a lot of effort to develop a full set of concentrate graphene nanotubes that help the customer not only to manage the product in production, but to make the process, the dispersion process, very, very easy, using your standard equipment, like high-shear cowless system or bead mill system. We have developed concentrate. They can be slurry, they can be pellet, they can be even liquid system for water-based and solid-based system that will fit your initial system, your initial chemistry, even if it is solvent-free, solvent-based, or water-based. And now let's focus on some applications, starting from flooring. As I told you, thanks to the very low working dosage, you see, if you are familiar with electrical properties, on the left, on the graph on the left, you see a typical percolation curve of graphene nanotubes. And as you can see, starting from a very low dosage, 0.01, 0.02 of graphene nanotubes in the total formulation, it is possible to achieve 10 to 5, 10 to 6 ohm per centimeter in terms of volume resistivity. Thanks to the very low working dosage, it is possible to develop colored product. And this kind of conductivity will remain for the entire life of your product. This makes possible to develop conductive antistatic coating that are compliant with international regulation. Here you see two examples of antistatic floor. In this specific case, you can have epoxy chemistry or you can have polyurethane chemistry. And these two chemistries were modified using our specific grade, matrix 301 or 202, to achieve a permanent and stable antistatic properties without hotspot on the surface. What it is important to remind is that using graphene nanotubes, it is very easy to pass the walking body voltage test. Application in lining. Thanks to the very low working dosage, it is possible to develop light coating, like RAL 7035, for example, and maintaining all the other properties unchanged that are important too. Like, for example, adhesion between the different layers, mechanical properties like impact resistance and crack resistance, and chemical resistance too. This is an application, this specific case. An epoxy system was modified, introducing our matrix to 1 at 0.3%, so it was possible to replace roughly 30% of conductive mica, to develop a coating with a surface resistivity below 10 to 8 ohm square, compliant with the target of the customer. Another added value that you can have using graphene nanotubes is the possibility to develop light color, and this fact will make, for example, the inspection of the final coating much, much easier. Powder application. Thanks to the high efficiency and a very low working dosage, the effect on the rheology or the final system will be very limited. This is why it is possible to use graphene nanotubes also to produce powder coating in the typical twin screw extruder process, maintaining all the other properties unchanged, like adhesion, like mechanical properties, like chemical resistance. This is an example. Antistatic powder painter for electronic equipment. We modified an epoxy system. Our customer modified the epoxy system with the matrix 815. This is a specific grade in pellet for a powder application. to achieve a surface resistivity 10 to 6 ohm square. What it is important to mention is that graphene nanotubes will bring conductivity to the final coolant in an independent way, considering the environment condition. So graphene nanotubes' effects are totally independent, for example, on the humidity. Application in automotive. This is a very interesting case. The application is for a conductive primer. Thanks to the very low working dosage, it is possible to develop light color with a very high efficiency in terms of transfer. And it is possible to develop a coating cycle, reducing the thickness, for example, of the base coat to achieve the final color target. These are two examples. Application is a coating for a plastic automotive component in these two specific examples. Two acrylic systems, one solvent-based and the other water-based, were modified using our specific grade to achieve a surface resistivity in the range 10 to 5, 10 to 6 ohm square without any hot spot effect. And now let's focus a little bit on textile application. There are different strategies that can be used to introduce properties in a textile. Textile can be coated with a specific coating, or the yarn can be coated itself before the weaving process, or the yarn itself can be modified in the inner material. Graphene nanotubes are so versatile that can be used in all these kinds of approaches to bring to the textile properties like ESD protection, like dust repellency, like touchscreen compatibility. Thanks again to the very low working dosage, it is possible to develop color product that will maintain the properties of the coating unchanged, like, for example, the mechanical, or in this specific case, the resistance to some chemicals like alkali, like oil resistance. We have developed a full range of product for textile application. They will cover each kind of chemistry. We have great for silicone, we have great for polyurethane, for PVC, for latex, and different kind of systems, solvent-based, solvent-free, and water-based. Here, in this slide, you see two interesting applications. One is for hospital bed covering for clean rooms. The other is for car seats. In these two cases, PU system chemistry was modified using our specific grade, matrix 202 or tuball coat E, in case you have a water-based system, to bring to the final coating a stable surface resistivity in the range of 10 to 6, 10 to 9 ohm per square, and bringing to the final coating anti-dust properties, preserving the mechanical and the chemical resistance of the initial coating. Protective wear are also possible. Again, here you see two specific examples where silicone chemistry was modified with our specific matrix 601 to achieve a surface resistivity in the range 10 to 6, 10 to 8 ohm square, that are compliant with international regulation. Another interesting property that you can have using graphene nanotubes, for example, is that no carbon release on the surface. Graphene nanotubes, they will strongly entangle in your polymer matrix, and they will never be released on the surface, like, for example, carbon black does. Before concluding, let me say a few words about OCSiAl. OCSiAl is a global leader in the production of graphene nanotubes, powder and concentrate, with the only scalable technology that makes this material available at industrial scale. We are more than 500 employees, and we are present in more than 50 countries with the production site, with R&D center, technical centers, sales offices, and distributor. And with a team of more than 100 people in R&D department and technical department, we can support our customer in each phase of their projects, since the very beginning R&D activities up to the industrialization scale. If you want to discuss about graphene nanotubes, or if you want to even open a project with us, we have a booth here at ECS, hall 1, 520. Thank you very much for your attention.